We last saw how Eddie Brock bonded with the Venom symbiote to fight Carnage, who bonded with the Grindel symbiote and became more powerful than ever. After a fierce battle in which Eddie almost lost his life, he decided to pay Peter Parker a visit. In the coffee bean, Spider-Man sits with Eddie and Dylan, lamenting how much he hates the symbiotes. Eddie thanks Spider-Man for meeting them. He tells Dylan to go sit at the counter while he and Spider-Man get into some serious talk. Spider-Man tells Eddie to explain why he has a child with him. Eddie says that Dylan is his son. Spider-Man remarks that he has not heard Dylan addressing Eddie as his father and asks if he knows. Eddie replies that Dylan thinks that he is his half-brother and that he is afraid to tell him the truth. Eddie spots a news report on TV. The news anchor speaks about the discovery of a mass grave in New Jersey in the shape of a spiral. The anchor says that the mass grave was constructed in a way that it was meant to be found, and that the bodies inside had already been dead for months, and in some cases years, and all had their spines removed. The anchor begins listing some of the bodies found, including that of General Thunderbolt Ross. Angered, Eddie states that all the bodies belong to people who had bonded to a symbiote, and that this is a message from Cletus Kasady saying that even being dead will not stop him from targeting you. Suddenly, three armed robbers burst into the coffee bean, telling everyone to get down on the floor. One of them, however, curses the moment they got into the shop upon seeing Spider-Man, who pummeled them. Spider-Man says that they need to find a way of extracting the codexes without killing the people they are in, noting that he would ask Reed Richards, but in the time frame they have, he would need to have started months ago. Eddie says that he knows someone who can help. Later, Venom and Dylan arrive at Rick Strickland's warehouse to find the Maker busy assembling a machine. Greeting Eddie, the Maker notes that he got his call and that it's about time Carnage made his move. Eddie asks about the machine, and the Maker replies that it's a device for non-lethally extracting codexes, which he built 35 days ago. He says that he had hoped to test it on Flash Thompson. Spider-Man then interrupts their conversation and introduces Normie Osborn. The Maker rebukes Spider-Man's attempts to introduce himself and says that he knows him well, and that he is the incarnation of Reed Richards from the Ultimate Universe. The Maker identifies Normie as a former host of the Carnage symbiote and says that he wants to take a blood sample before they begin. Eddie and Spider-Man protectively stand in front of Normie and Dylan, with Spider-Man refusing to let the Maker use the machine on his godson until he knows it's safe. The Maker tells them to find someone else with a codex he can test the machine on, adding that surely there is someone highly dangerous who would make for an obvious candidate that Cletus Kasady would target. Spider-Man and Eddie realize right away that he is referring to Norman Osborn. Up next, we will see how Spider-Man and Venom try to get Norman Osborn to be tested by the Maker, only to end up confronting the Carnage in the third and the final chapter of this incredible book. Stay tuned, and don't forget to subscribe, share, and like. Thanks for watching, and have a nice one.